Hello, viewers. Hello, viewers. You are welcome to a new lesson today. Today, I'm going to teach you how to create simple logo. So I will say this is just a preamble, practical steps. So today, I'm going to teach you how to create simple logo. Just simple logo. I'm going to use CorelDRAW to design simple logo. And what type of logo? Which logo are we going to design? I want to use what is it called? Glow logo as an example. So let's use Glow logo. Let's see how we can design Glow logo in just 2 minutes. So it's very simple to create. Very simple to create Glow logo. So if you can create Glow logo, it means you can also design any other logo. So that is it. So please, let's go by launching our CorelDRAW. And I want to believe you've already known how to launch CorelDRAW. You know how to launch CorelDRAW. You are already a computer literate. So in order to launch CorelDRAW, you can either click on Start, then click on All Programs. Then when you click on All Programs, then scroll down to where you see Corel Graphics Suite 13. In this case, we have different versions of Corel Graphics Suite. We have Corel Graphics Suite 13, the Corel Graphics Suite 14, 15, 16, and 17 as at present. So please though we have old versions of CorelDRAW, old version of CorelDRAW service starting from CorelDRAW 1 to 10, 11, 12, but the new and the latest version ranges from 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17 presently. So now how do we go about it? When you click on Start, when you click on Start, click on All Programs, then click scroll down to where you see Corel Graphics Suite, then click on it as you choose it, then click on CorelDRAW 13. It will launch this way. Another way of launching it is you can also launch it from the taskbar here, or you click on Start, click on CorelDRAW here. So that is, we have different way of launching CorelDRAW. So now we want to open a new page. As you can see, the page is very empty. The page is very empty, and then you need to create a new page layout. To do that, what you need to do is to click on File and click on New, or better still, click on New, or better still, Control N. Press Control N from your keyboard, it will open a new. Press Control N, it will just open a new page layout for you. But I'm closing this now. So I say that I come here also, and now I come to New. So whichever way. So I click on New from the standard toolbar. So whichever way. Now let me quickly introduce the window to you, because we need, once you launch it, you need to observe the window. As you can see, here is the toolbar. Here is the toolbar. This row is the toolbar. And the second row is menu bar. We have the second row as menu bar. And we have the third row as a standard toolbar. We have the third row as a standard toolbar, and we have the fourth row as the horizontal, I'm sorry, property bar. We have the fourth row as the property bar. We have it as property bar. Then we have this row and this row as what? Horizontal stroke vertical ruler bar. Then we have this row, this column rather, this bar and this bar, we have them as horizontal stroke vertical scroll bar. Then we have our color palette. This is our color palette, as you can see. So these are, we're going to make use of this color later. This is CMYK, and what's the full meaning of CMYK, which is cyan, magenta, yellow, black. The K is standing for black. That is cyan, magenta, yellow, black. CMYK. And we also have another color here, color palette here, which is RGB, which is a red, green, blue. And it's another color palette. Where do we see these colors? Where do we bring them out? What you do is you click on Windows. From Windows, click on color palette. From color palette, choose either of the two. Choose either of the two. But I have chosen the two here. I placed this at this corner, and I placed this at this corner, at this corner, at the bottom of the window. So now that in the most powerful tool or box you need to know here is toolbox. It's your toolbox. So with your toolbox, you can create and create and create anything. So without full orientation, let me just continue creating the logo, because later you learn the full package of it. But like I told you, this is just a preamble of preamble practical of how to create logos or how to create graphics. So in order to go on now, you don't need to set up your page because you are not making use of the full paper, you are not making use of the full page. So there's no need of setting up the page. If not, I will have said, okay, choose your paper size. So where do you choose your paper size? You come to property bar. From property bar, you can choose your paper size, maybe A4 or whichever. You know, most of our printers these days, they will come out with A4 paper. So that is why generally you use A4. But in this case, we don't need either A4, A3 or whatever. We just need a logo. We are not creating a full page. We are not creating a diary paper. We are not creating documents. We are not designing full content. So in that case, there will be no need of measuring my size or choosing page units for it. Like if you want to create a banner, create banner, create a flares, create a, what is called SAV and all these large formats and a billboard printout, then you can use either inches or feet. But feet is mostly used. So but in order to, let me go on, I don't want to bombard your brain with this simple logo we want to create. Like I told you, what we want to create is simple logo. We want to create simple logo, and we are using glow logo as an example. So to continue, just go to your toolbox. In your toolbox, choose what? Rectangle. As you choose rectangle, draw a rectangle. You can draw it in any size, in any form. You can draw it in any size, in any form. The same, because you, once you finish creating it, you can reduce it or you enlarge it. You can increase it. You can increase the size. You can reduce the size. So you can draw it in any form. So as you have drawn the rectangle, then go to your color. Choose color green. And as you have chosen color green, now how do you choose your color green? I did the normal clicking, left click on the color. So in order to choose my color, I do the left click on the color. So I want to remove the line. As you can see, let me go to line and stay and show you the line. You can see it's having black line. So if I want to remove the line, what I do, I right click on the color box. I right click on the color box to remove the line. Now I have removed it, so no line. So the next thing to do, go to your ellipse tool. From ellipse tool, click and draw circle. So if you want to draw circle, please take note, there's a difference between circle and ellipse. If now this is, look at this. This one is what is a horizontal ellipse, and this is a vertical ellipse. Just the same thing as rectangle. If you are creating rectangle, this is horizontal rectangle and this is a vertical rectangle. So but if you want to create a box or cube, you have to hold down your control key and draw equal size of a box or your equal size of rectangle called box or cube. So now, and if you want to draw ellipse too, now let me delete them one by one. I'm deleting them one by one. So now if you want to create this ellipse, so what you need to do is when you click on it, hold down your control key so that you can have equal size of a ellipse called circle. Now I have this. Now that I have done this, now click on a outline where you see airline. So that is outline width. Click there on the property bar. From your property bar, click on it, then choose size for it. Now I'm choosing eight. Then right click to give it white color. As you can see, we now have outline white color, but we need to mix the color inside. So how do you do that? So come to fill color. On the fill color tool, choose 14 fill. From your 14 fill, come to linear type. Under type, choose radial. So as you choose radial, come to color blend. Under color blend, you want to blend colors together. Now you are blending two colors together, so we're going to blend color green and white. Though in graphics, white is no color. In graphics, white is no color, but in this case, primarily, let me call it a color. So choose two colors here, then come here, choose color green, then come here, choose color white. So in that case, you can bisect it here. So you are setting the offset. So I'm offsetting it here. So now, to me, this is too sharp. It's too sharp. So let me go back again. I come here. I come to 40 film, under 40 film. Then I set up my midpoint. I adjust my midpoint like that. So as you can see, you can have this. So as you have this, now next thing to do, and the green, I can change the green to different kind of green, you know, glow. Sometimes they use lighter green, sometimes they use darker green. So if you observe them, if you follow them very well, you observe what I'm saying. So now let me change the green to the green color to another one. So come here, come to fill color as well, then 40 fill. So from 40 fill, click on color green, where you see color green from color blend, click on color green, then from front box, then choose other. So when you choose other, you can make it more darker here. Now I can, this is the old one and this is the new one. So click on okay. Now I have that, so I cannot click on okay. Oh, this one is too dark. It's off the distance. So let's leave it the way it was. So I think I like it the way it is, because sometimes glow also uses it this way. So now what you need to do now is to type glow. Go to your test tool. As you are in your test tool, type glow. Just type glow in lowercase. Then increase the size, then bring it down here. Now I want to bold it. Click on bold from the property bar. Or you can call it font box, because anytime you choose test two from your toolbox, the property will change to font formatting bar. It will change to formatting bar. The property will change to formatting bar. So what is property bar? Property bar displays the properties of any chosen tool from the toolbox. So anytime you choose a tool from the toolbox, the property bar will display the properties or the features of that particular tool you have just chosen. So that is what is happening here when I chose test tool to type this glow. So now bold it, come to property bar, you see bold it, then you can increase it. Please never increase like this. Never increase in this direction, and please never increase in this direction, and please never increase or reduce in this direction, and please never increase or reduce direction. So what you want to do is you want to increase randomly. So if you want to increase randomly or reduce randomly, you choose the corner node. So this is a corner node, another corner node, another corner node, and another corner node. So choose the corner node. So I'm choosing any of the corner node to either increase or reduce. So now leave it this way. Now give it color white. That is it. So now that we have this now, so well, now if you check glow logo very well, you discover there's an open space here from the G. The G has an open space. So what you need to do is to zoom it. As you zoom it, click on rectangle, then draw a rectangle to cover that place. Draw a rectangle to cover the place. So as you draw that rectangle to cover the place, then hold down your shift key. Select the rectangle that you have just drawn. Hold down your shift key. Then select the glow. Select the G or the glow. Then trim it. Click on trim from the property bar. So when you select two objects together, the properties or the features of two objects selected together will display in the property bar. So what you need to do now is to trim. Click on trim. It will trim it off this way. Then select the rectangle you drew over and delete. Now, as you can see, you are having little comma here. So what you need to do now is to choose your shape tool. When you choose your shape tool, click on it. Then double click here to remove. Double click on this node to remove. Double click on this one to remove. Then it will perfect it this way. So now, please reduce the zoom. Then you have something of this nature. So now, please come here and type. Go to your test tool and type "Rule Your World." Their slogan is short. Is "Rule Your World." So exclamation mark. To press to get the exclamation mark is shift one. So when you type your shift one, you press shift and press one, you get your exclamation mark. So I'm having this. So I bring it down here. Then I need to change the font name. So I want to change the font name to script. Click on the font. If you, as you can see, because I typed as the formatting bar displayed, and where you, where we can now have font, font name, font size, bold, italics, underline, alignment, or down, so on and so forth. Excuse me, please. Now click on a font name. Under font name, type script. Type script. So I'm choosing script empty bold. Then I give it color white. Then I print that. Of course, you can give it any color. Of course, you can give it any color. I mean, sorry, any, not any color. It's going to be color white. I mean, any font name. So I can choose another font name that's somehow related to what, or something of this nature that's somehow related. So I can choose any font name that's somehow related. So that is just it. So I want to believe, excuse me, I want to believe you really enjoyed the class, and this is just a tip of the iceberg. I, like I told you, it's a preamble practical. So this is just how to design Glow logo. Of course, you can design Glow logo or any type of logo in any dimension, but this is just a simple way that I've just shown you. I can use any other way to design, or so many other ways to design this same logo, but I have just shown you this simple logo, and I believe you are going to enjoy it. Please lay your hand on system every day to continue practicing. The more you practice, the more you get to know it more. The more you get to know it. So thank you so much. God bless you. Please follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Instagram. Follow us on Facebook. And also, most importantly, follow us and subscribe to our YouTube channel, ZTech IT Solution. On Facebook, ZTech IT Solution. On Twitter, ZTech IT Solution. On Instagram, ZTech IT Solution. Most importantly, on YouTube, ZTech IT Solution. Please go there, watch most of our videos. Watch most of our videos. You see on videos on web design, videos on programming, videos on graphic design, videos on in digital marketing. Go there and subscribe to our channel. God bless you. Learn more. Any day you stop learning, that means you are no more. There is no amount of knowledge that is a waste. Always make sure you learn every day. Thank you so much. May God bless you. Have a blessed day ahead. Thank you.